it's me, Vicky Bunny, / I Don't Work Here Lady, where we will read I Got Promoted While Shopping at a Store I Don't Work At. So yesterday, I was at my favorite local supermarket. I've been shopping there pretty much once a week for the past 6 years. I know the place like the back of my hand. I know most of the employees by name. I live in a small town of 4,000 people. As I am standing in the taco aisle trying to decide exactly how hard to punish my bathroom later, I picked ghost pepper salsa. So a lot. I am approached by a woman who must have been 75 if she was a day. SL will be a sweet lady and M will be me. SL, son, can you help me locate the aluminum foil? M, sure, it's right up this way. Walks her aisle to aisle 7B. M, it's pretty high up. Let me grab it for you. Do you want the Reynolds or the store brand? SL, the name brand, please. Hands her a 200-foot roll. M, do you need help finding anything else? I'm a walking directory of this store. SL, hands me her shopping list. I spent about 10 minutes filling her cart with heavy, hard-to-reach items, and then I got back to my shopping with a smile and a have a great day. As I'm standing in the checkout, I see the SL arguing with the floor manager. Greg, he goes to my church. We're pretty familiar with each other. Over by the express line. I pay for my groceries and walk over to be nosy and maybe help out. SL is telling Greg that the big guy with the red beard helped her. I didn't get his name, and she wants to see him get a bonus, promotion, or employee of the month, something. Greg is insistent that no one with that description works there. I get to the counter, and before I can explain that I don't even work there, Greg pipes up. G to SL. Oh, you mean Mark? Yeah, he's one of our best employees. G to me. Mark, this lady has been over here singing your praises for the past 5 minutes. I didn't even know you were working today. Me, lying through my teeth. Well, Sharon, a cashier I know, called me and said we were slammed, so I came in on my day off. Gee, well that's some real initiative. How would you like to be assistant to be regional manager? We're both huge office fans. M, oh my gosh, thank you, are you sure? Gee, well you've definitely earned it. SL, see, this is why I shop here instead of Walmart. Even though you guys charge more, you care about your employees, and your employees care about your customers. So that is how I became assistant to the regional manager at a store I am not even employed by. Okay, our next post. Do you know who I am? And you're fired until they realized their terrible mistake. I need to be vague about the work involved, otherwise it's too easy to identify the parties involved. My friend David is skilled in a very niche area of construction. He repairs and renovates buildings using a very old construction method that hasn't been common for several centuries. All his work is on conversation projects and listed buildings. Work was required on a grade 1 listed property. The overall building work was being done by the main contractor ACC LTD. One part of the work is very specialized. The contractor's managers didn't know anyone who did it to the architect, gave them a list of qualified people. The contractors chose my friend because he had the earliest availability. 5 days into the work, the owner of ACC LTD, the main contractor company, arrived on site. He was throwing his weight around and being a nosy gobshiz. David's words. David was just doing his job and ignored him. Nosy Gobsheet told one of his carpenters to get him a coffee. The carpenter disappeared. Nosy Gobsheet continued wandering and gobbing off about dailies, costing him a fortune. 15 minutes after the carpenter had disappeared, the Nosy Gobsheet asked my friend a question. Nosy Gobsheet, where is that effing Chippy with my coffee? Chippy equals carpenter. David, don't know. Nosy Gobsheet, go and find out. David, I'm only here for this job, pointing to the walls. I don't work for ACC LTD. Nosy Gobsheet, I don't give a foof whether you're an employee or a subcontractor. You still work for me. Now go and find my effing coffee. David, firstly, I don't appreciate being talked to like that, and secondly, my contract with you is to do these walls, nothing more. I'm definitely not a gopher. Nosy Gobsheet, oh, you don't appreciate being talked to like that, do you? Which subcontractor do you work for? David, none, I'm self-employed, it's just me. Nosy Gobsheet, an effing day laborer? And you've got the nerve to talk to like that. Do you know who I am? David, yep. Nosy Gobsheet, well, you're effing fired. Get off the effing site now. David, okay, put it in writing. Noisy gobshit, F off, just get off the effing site. David pulled his phone out and started recording. David, okay, I'll go. I just want proof you told me to go. Noisy gobshit grabbed David's hand holding the phone and screamed into the phone. Noisy gobshit, get off the site, you effing idiot. You're fired. If you're still here in 10 effing minutes, I'll have you effing thrown out. David, cool, no problem. He picked up all his kit and walked away. As he was leaving the contractor's site, manager passed him, ironically with a coffee for the boss, and with a smile said, site manager, you leaving early, Dave? Bloody part-timer's joking. David, no, your boss just fired me. Our contract is ended. Sorry, mate. Site manager, no. Let me sort this out. Wait, please wait. David left. The site manager was losing his shiz because he knew something that Noisy Gobsheet didn't. Only 7 people in the UK are qualified to do the work. They all have a waiting list, and David had been the only one available. By the time he was home, he had 12 missed calls. That was Thursday. 2 working days missed so far. He said he'll go back, but only if he gets paid for the extra days and has a genuine apology in person from the boss. I met my friend when he was getting a call from the site manager saying the boss apologizes but is out of the country, so can't apologize, F2F. David also told me he phoned the other specialists to warn them, but they'd all been phoned on Friday begging them to do the job. Nobody took the work. They're all booked solid. David also phoned the architect to warn him. Situations like this, some unscrupulous contractors try to bodge the job and fake the work. David is going to stick to his guns, pay for all missed days, plus F2F apology. He is sure he'll get it. I've said I'll pay anything to watch the F2F apology. Update. Site manager phoned to say he was told by Nosy Gobsheet to threaten legal action if David doesn't finish the job. Site manager was very embarrassed and apologetic. David reminded him he didn't leave and has proof that he was fired. Site manager phoned again to say Nosy Gobsheet will apologize F2F on Friday. Can David start tomorrow? David said no. Following the threat of legal action, the conditions are different. Number 1. F2F apology before work restarts. 2. Added pay for wasted days. 3. Payment of full contract value up front before work starts. 4. All must happen by Thursday. That's the last day he can start and still expect to finish before his next booking. If he also works the weekends, he has just enough time. I asked him why he isn't charging a huge extra amount for the guy being such a wanker. He said, it doesn't look good if you take advantage of companies when they're under time pressure. Not the done thing. It seems that one of my friends is an 18th century gentleman. Correction, I misunderstood David when he said only 7 others do this work. He meant 7 other businesses apart from his. They're small businesses, so he says it's probably about 20 people who can do it. Still a small amount, but not as comically small as 7. Sorry for misleading you all about the number. Update 2. Unfortunately, it seems there will be no apology. David was discovered that the site manager was blamed for not making Noisy Gobsheet aware of the situation beforehand, and was fired. David contacted the operations director for ACC LTD, Noisy Gobsheet's number 2, and informed them that an apology is no longer required as he will not be returning to the job. The ops director apologized for everything and offered to renegotiate the money very generously. David told him that he had only considered going back to the job as a personal favor to the original site manager. Since he isn't there, he feels no obligation to return. Ops director said he will get back to David, but didn't say why. I asked why he didn't say give him his job back or I won't come back. David said Noisy Gobsheet is too petty and weak to be told what to do by a craftsman. It will have to be the company's idea for the site manager to come back. If I tell them to bring him back, it won't happen. David says the site manager is great at his job, but is only 4 years from the retirement, so it's not easy to find a job at 61. I've decided I like David even more than I did 3 days ago. Update 3. It's 2 a.m. here. We've just got back from the pub. David got a call while we were out from the sacked site manager. David updated the architect on the situation this afternoon. The architect contacted the site sacked manager to tell him about a company who needs a site manager. The sacked site manager phoned David just before 9 p.m. I had to sit
everyone,
through the phone
thank
call
you all for watching my video.
I must subscribe to read more Reddit like I'd got an article of sparrows.
The next one.
Then David filled me in. The site manager rang to thank him and to find out his favorite drink so he can send him a bottle. He hasn't got the new job yet, but he is seeing them on Friday. Apparently, the architect's recommendation carries some weight, so he's optimistic. David refuses at first. I didn't get you a job, the architect did. The site manager said, but you set all this shiz in motion and told the architect that I'd been fired. Because of you, I never need a deal with that obnoxious pillock ever again. David wasn't specific about the two obnoxious pillock was. We'll have to guess. David said his drink is Cardew Gold Reserve. He said he will accept a bottle only if the site manager gets the new job, and B, if the site manager will come over and drink the Cardew with David. It looks like the handsome scribe who did the enormously difficult time-consuming job of skillfully writing the Sega down on Reddit isn't included in the whiskey consumption. As David poetically put it, you can buy your own effing drink. Sorry guys, if you can hear like barking and howling, that's just my mom speaking to our dog there. All good news, hopefully, except that nobody gets to see that tosspot, noisy gopshi, eat shiz when he has to apologize. I was so looking forward to that. Additional information. David and the fire site manager know each other outside of work. Each are members of charity organizations in the same town. Two different groups, but they work together a lot. Site manager is in Rotary Club. David is in Roundtable. I don't think he's a knight, but you never know. Update 4. Operations director for ACC LTD phoned David to suggest that they take the site manager back and generously renegotiated the money. David says they've missed the boat. There is no way he can finish the job on his own before he starts his next job. There is an absolute minimum of 11 days work left. If everything goes without a hitch, David's next job starts 4th November. Only 10 days left if he works both weekends. Too late. I wish I could be a fly on the wall when a noisy gobshit is told. The most common question. Many are asking what David does. If I said what it was, it's so identifying that I might as well give you his real name and his address. Sorry. The reason there are very few of them is it takes 5 years to become just competent and at least 9 years to be a master craftsman. The jobs need at least one master present when the work is done. Update 5. Bad news. The fired site manager didn't get the other job. He met the new company, but they're not taking him on. The reasons aren't clear. David is meeting him on Sunday to discuss it. I can tell David feels like shiz about it, even though it's not his fault. Site manager says he's going to take action for unfair dismissal. I thought this was going to be a win-win-win, but I suppose life isn't like that. Update 6. News about the sacked manager. The situation isn't as bad as we first thought. I think we misunderstood what happened on Friday. David talked to him yesterday. The company he saw on Friday are not employing him in the normal way. That part was correct, but they have offered him a fixed term contract for 18 months on a distribution center build. It's not perfect, but on the bright side, it's slightly better paid than ACC. It's only 18 months, but that's better than nothing. There is also the chance that the new company might extend the contract if another project comes in. Update 7. 7? Seriously? David has heard that they're getting a Bulgarian to come over to do the job. David was grinning when he told me. He thinks he knows what will happen. There was a similar but different technique that was used on some 19th century buildings in Sofia. David thinks that's the guy will use that technique. It looks similar, but two very important materials are different. David has decided to wait. He plans to let the Bulgarian finish the job and get paid. Then David is going to suggest to the planning department and the client that they check the two components. Unless the Bulgarian knows the 17th century English method, he will have used the wrong materials. It would mean ripping it out and starting again. They are incredibly strict with this type of work. I shouldn't want this so much, but I really hope this happens. I'm a petty man. Further information. Many people are asked, when will David know if the Bulgarian has done the job right? David might know fairly soon, since there are very few suppliers of one of the materials. If the Bulgarian contacts them, David will be told. David's words, it's a tiny incestuous part of the industry, and they gossip like old women. Correction, we all gossip like women. If he doesn't go there, David is leaving it alone until he is told that the work is finished and the Bulgarian is paid. He doesn't want to put the guy's money at risk. In David's words, I don't want the Bulgarian to drag his arse over here and go home empty-handed just because I can't wait to chop silly bollocks. The man's got a living to earn. I'll wait. Just in case of confusion, silly bollocks is the same person as nosy gobshite. It should take the Bulgarian about 3 weeks to finish the job unless he works weekends. David knows plenty of people on site and a few at ACC head office, so he'll know when the job is finished. So I've got to sit on my hands for 3-4 weeks and pretend I'm not an excited 7-year-old girl pissing at her pants about Christmas coming. Update 8. David has been told that the Bulgarian got straight to it and started work. He's had materials delivered, but from an ordinary building supplier, the stuff he needs to do the job properly is too bulky for him to bring with him even if they sell it in Bulgaria. He hasn't ordered it from the UK supplier. They are three, but only one has enough for his job because they got it in for David. So unless it is coming by road and ferry, he is not using the right materials. David wouldn't allow it to go unreported even if he wasn't annoyed about nosy gobshite. He's got a genuine passion for looking after all these buildings he works on, and he is a purist when it comes to historical accuracy. So now I have to hold my water for 3-4 weeks. David says that if he's using more modern materials, he might finish soon. 3 weeks is the time it takes if you stay in the 17th century. I've turned into a bit of a weirdo about this job. When I phoned David earlier on a pretext, he realized I was after info again. David, foof me, do you want me to fit a body cam so you can see and hear everything as it happens? Me, if it's not too much trouble and you can link me into your phone calls, that'd be nice. David, after laughing, you effing no cheese. Is it okay if I cover the lens when I'm shizzing and shagging my wife? Me, personally, I don't do those two things at the same time, but whatever floats your boat. David, you're telling me you do them separately when you are shagging my wife? Me, right after she's cleaned all the shiz off the sheets from doing you, some of us are foosy. David, piss off. You're an uptight clean freak. Hangs up. No, goodbye. No, see you soon. English manners aren't what they used to be. I know it doesn't look like it, but honestly, I do have a life, I promise. TLDR, owner of contracting firm fires, subcontractor without realizing nobody else can do the essential work. Lots of shizzin ensues. Oh my, and there's update 9, and if you want to go there, go on this post. Comments. This is my favorite story on this sub so far. It has everything. I don't work here. Don't you know who I am? Malicious compliance, a-hole tax, pro-revenge, all together. This is like the omnibus of stories. He even called the other folks who do this work and warned them too. Just incredible. 10-10. Okay, everyone, thank you all for watching. That was a crazy story. It was all these subreddits all in one. Okay, everyone, thank you all for watching my video. Subscribe to read more Reddit posts with me and see you guys in the next one.